Hello guys, welcome to SWK Tutorials. Today I will be teaching you guys how to model a fort using reference images. The first thing that we have to do when we are using reference images is that we have to check our references for sizes in Photoshop. What do I mean by this? Let me just explain you. Open the image in Photoshop. Press Ctrl R, click here with left mouse button and drag it till here. Again left click and drag this line here. Next, import your other image. Now if you can see in my previous image, the fork is that much big. You can see here, the fork is that much big, but my top image is not of equal size. So what I have to do is that I have to go to Edit, Free Transform. Make sure your top image is selected. I'm using Photoshop 2019, so I will simply drag it like this. In previous versions you have to press Shift so that your ratios are equal. Press Enter to keep complete the command. Now both of my reference images, that is side and top, are of equal ratio. Save them and import them in 3ds Max. Since I have two reference images, that is top and side, plus I need perspective viewport to see my model. So I will set three viewports in 3ds Max instead of these four. I will go to View, Viewport Configuration. If some changes comes in future versions of 3ds Max in viewport configuration, I will mention it in description. For now, simply click here. Click OK. I need top here and left here and this one perspective. Press set to bring it like this. Now I will set my reference images. First I will check our reference image size. Select it, right click, object properties, details. It's 512 by 512, so it means my reference image is of equal size. Check this one too. Again, this is also 512 by 512, it means it's a perfect square. Second step, change your unit setup to generic units. Click OK. Now make a plane. Go to Modify, change length and width to 512 by 512, length segments and width segments to 11, and it's better to take it to 00. Next, clone it and rotate it in the left viewport in a way that you can see it properly. Change it to minus 90. It can be minus 90 or positive 90 depending on your viewport. Select top plane, open material editor, assign material, click here, double click bitmap and assign top image. Make sure to click Show Shaded Material in Viewport. I can use the same technique for this plane too. But if you are a lazy person like me, then simply drag this side image on this plane. Our reference images are not correctly orientated. So select this, turn on Angle Snap, right click on the Angle Snap to open its options. Set the angle to 90 degrees. and rotate your plane. Take it up like this and move it back. Select this and also rotate it like this. Again, move it a little bit down. Then select both the planes, right click and choose freeze. Oops, we can't see the image because we freeze the plane. To fix this, right click, unfreeze all. Again, select both planes, right click and choose object properties. Check freeze and uncheck show frozen in gray. This will freeze the object, but the image will appear. Click OK. Now I can see both the images, but I cannot accidentally change my reference planes. I don't want the grid, so I will hide them by pressing G and again G. These are the basic steps that I always do whenever I am creating a model from reference images. It can be a car or a plane, etc. Create a box. If you can see here, I cannot see my reference images in both of these viewports. Turn on see-through mode. Right click, object properties, see-through. Or you can simply press X on the keyboard. Convert it to editable poly. For reference modeling, this is very important that I'm about to tell you. If you have just manipulated a vertex or edge in one viewport like this, I'm manipulating these vertex, then go to the second viewport and adjust them here too. Remember guys, this is extremely important if you are doing reference modeling. I have seen a lot of students doing this mistake. They actually adjust the object in one viewport and leave the other. Never do this. If you adjust the vertex in one viewport or edge, then quickly come to the other viewport and adjust them here too. If you adjust them here, then you have to first adjust them here before moving forward. Now select a face, right click, extrude, click OK. I have pressed F4 to turn on my edges. Now I will place it somewhere here at extreme change. You can see that this is the part where I am getting extreme change. So I will come here too, and in this viewport I will adjust it like this. I am not going to worry too much about these curves right now. These curves. Press Alt W. Right click, extrude again. Bring it somewhere here. If you can see, this is the part where I'm getting the change. So again, I will bring it like this. I will just adjust it like this. Alt W, and again, I will come into this other viewport and I'm going to adjust it like this. This time, vertex is a better option. You can see it like this. Click here, right click, extrude, and this time I will come till here. Again, scale it, go to this viewport, vertex, click here, adjust it like this, and adjust it like this. Okay guys, now I have to work on two parts. I have to work on this part here and I have to work on this part here. For this part, I need to extrude it 1, 2, 3 and 4 into 4 pieces. But if you look at our fork, it has one piece. Press Alt X to off it see-through mode. You can see it is one piece. And one more thing. This part is little bit straight. I need one edge here because this is also an extreme. So I need a way to insert edges. What I will do is that I will click on edge. I will select this edge. I will click on ring to get a loop here. Then I will right click and I will click on connect. I will click OK and then I will move it in this viewport. Let's say like this. Press Z to zoom. And in this viewport, I will drag it little bit down. Like this. Right click and insert an edge here too. Slide it like this, close to this part, click OK and then move it to the extreme. So I will just do it like this too. Okay, now the basic part here is okay and you know we have to make these two parts. So first I will be doing this part. Now to get lines at this part, if you can see, I just press Alt X. To get lines at this part, I need to click any one of these lines and then press ring. It will give me a loop. Next, Alt W, right click and press connect. Click on connect option this time. Increase it to one more. 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And click OK. This is going to give me equal distance edges. And it is also extremely important if you are doing modeling. Click here and drag it like this. First, I will bring it little bit forward like this, then press Alt X and now I will adjust it something like this. When you are happy, just bring it back to its original place here. Now, I will click here, 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 and here. And I will extrude them again. Press Alt X. Bring it here and scale them down like this. Again, move them here. Okay guys, now what I'm about to do is that make sure you don't deselect any one of them. Bring it close like this and adjust any one of them. Just try to make it approximately the same. Now go to your vertex and move them like this. What I have done is that I have set one of them equal in width and all of them are set. But since their position was not right, so I move them with my X. Next, select all of them and bring it up like this. Move them like this. Okay, guys, at this point, I just want to mention you guys one more thing, that sometimes using the alt text technique is not that much good. If you press F3, you can't see anything. But with alt text, you can see it's not working here because I have actually three more objects behind this object. So what I can do is that press alt text again. Instead of using the see-through mode, I can simply use my standard material, apply it here, and I can just slow down the opacity. You can see now it's easy for me. Select all of them by dragging right now so that you can see all the lines selected. Right click, go to connect and enter the edges you want. I think so 3 will be okay for me and I will click okay. Now I will bring them down like this. One more thing, guys, before I do this thing, just take it down like this. Since we are taking the benefit of materials, so I will do like this. Then I will select all of them from here, right click, connect options, and 3 are okay. Go to your vertex, bring it down like this. Also bring them down like this and bring it down like this. Go to your top viewport and see for any mistake. Okay, no mistake here. Now we are done with all this part. Now we have to just deal with this part here and this part here. Select all of them. Control left click to deselect this part. Right click, extrude. Just bring this value down till here. Click OK. Next, bring it up like this. I think so we haven't done it properly. There is a little bit of mistake in my reference, but it's not that much big. Bring it down like this. Again, press Alt to deselect both of them. Do it like this and deselect both of them too and bring it down like this. Scale it down like this. Now I have to adjust all of these vertex to give it a curve like this. In reference modeling, most of the time, like 95% or 99% of the time, there will be slight difference in your image planes. So we just adjust it like this. Next, again, connect, come towards this side and go for a scale like this. This side down like this. This part is going to be down like this. Again, this edge like this. Click OK and scale it like this. Bring it down like this. Go to the vertex and again bring it down like this. You can see I'm continuously doing this thing. If I'm adjusting it in one viewport, then I'm quickly going to the other viewport and adjusting it there too. Since this part is a curved part, so I need more edges here and I'm giving it. But make sure don't overdo this thing too much. Next, it's okay, but I always prefer if something in my modeling, if it's a extremely long distance and I don't have an edge, so I usually put one edge in the center. Okay, it's better if I give one more edge here, because I think it's better and it will give me a better shape too. Bring it inside like this, click here, loop it, or you can simply select the vertex. It's up to you. Okay guys, again, I have to be extremely careful with this thing. If I'm changing it at one place, so I have to be careful and change it at other place too. Okay guys, now my base model is done. I have made my fork with the reference images. Now I will apply a turbo smooth. First I will press F4, and now I will apply a turbo smooth to see my shape. I will increase its iterations to 2. I'm happy with these curves. I have no issue here, but this part is too much curve. On this part is pointy. So how can I stop this curve and this pointness? Okay guys, now understand the turbo smooth concept. Far edges, on applying turbo smooth, far edges makes it more curvy, but close edges make it more sharp. When you apply a turbo smooth on an object, if the edges are far in distance, you will get smooth corners. And when the edges are close in distance, you will get sharp corners. You can see, when the edges are far, you get smooth. And when the edges are close, you get sharp. Hopefully you guys understand this thing. It is an extremely important concept if you want to be a good modeler. So, to stop this curve, what I will do, I will click on edge, press F4 on the keyboard so that I can see my edges. Click here and make a ring. Next, I will right click, go to connect and insert an edge in the center. Now, if I apply turbo smooth, you can see that it's a lot better than the previous time. I'm happy with this, but I'm still not happy with this part. I want it to be more flat. So I have to come here, turn off my turbo smooth, and as we have already learned here, to get sharp edges or sharp corners, I need to close my edge distance. Right now, what I will do is that I will select all of these edges, right click, go to connect and increase its distance so that I get a close edge over here. Now, when I'm going to turn on turbo smooth, you can see that this part is hard. Next, again I will turn off my turbo smooth by clicking on the eye. I will click on vertex, and what I will do is that I will drag it like this, and I will move my this like this. So guys, now I am happy with my fork. Just a quick summary of this tutorial. If you want to do reference modeling, then first import all of your reference in Photoshop. Make sure to set the guidelines and see that all the images have proper sizes. They are equal in sizes. Next, when you start modeling, you can press Alt X to use the see-through mode, or you can apply material and decrease its opacity. And the most important thing, whenever you adjust a vertex here, then you have to adjust it here too. If you adjust a vertex or edge in one viewport, remember always to adjust in another viewport. This way you can do a very good reference modeling. I hope that this tutorial was helpful for you. If you like this tutorial, give it a like. If you love this tutorial, subscribe to my channel, share my videos. Keep creating, guys. Bye bye.